So let me ask you guys this. There's a lot of talk on the fights in the works. Miguel Cotto, Urokis Gamboa.
Now that's one.
That's a joke.
No, it's serious. No, serious. They're really discussing.
I know I was saying that, you know, fights are intriguing, but there's no intrigue in that fight. No. I mean, again, people are going to say, well, it's just like Triple G and Cal Brook, but I think it's different.
Why?
Gamboa, his chin is very suspect. And come on, that's
Cotto. He's been dropped a handful of times.
Guys that went from 130, 126, 135. I mean, so I just don't see that being a good fight at all. That's more of a freak show than anything.
And Cotto right now is looking like a cruiserweight, so.
So that's what I hear. I haven't seen him. I heard he's bigger.
I'd be more interested in seeing a rematch with Devin Rodriguez.
Delvin Rodriguez. Why?
You know, because I mean, you know, Delvin, at least he's gonna put up a fight.
He really disappointed me that first time, because I get phone calls from like different actors, celebrities, athletes, that, like, because they bet. I don't bet, and I said, no, this guy just coming off ESPN fight with the Paul Wallach. You remember they bumped heads, and I was like, he's gonna put up a war against Cotto. He's gonna beat Cotto, and he got blown out in a round and a half.
I mean, that happens. I mean, he got, you know.
He looks scared.
Sometimes the lights might have been too big for him.
You know, but I mean, that would probably be a better matchup.
They need to find someone else. Yeah. That's the bottom line.
How about John Molina against Miguel Cotto? John, would you take that fight?
At 40, 47?
47.
Yeah, man. Why not?
Would you beat Miguel Cotto?
Are you asking that question?
What if I sat there and said,
cut you out?
Well, geez, I don't know.
Miguel Cotto.
Depends on the weather.
Do you knock him out?
Come on, man. You're asking a fighter to.
I think so.
I'm saying you're asking a fighter. If you tell me I'm gonna fight Kovalev, I'm gonna knock him out. You know what I mean? Like, and again, I'm not saying like everyone to say, oh, look at John, fucking retarded. And
no, you're a fighter. You believe you'll beat anyone. That's the mentality you're supposed to have.
If I thought any other way, I shouldn't be in this game.
I agree. Even if you play basketball, you should believe.
You want to ask me the question,
Coach? Let's ask Shadid to Luis. Shadid, break down this fight: John Molina Jr., Miguel Cotto, 147. If it happened in 3 months,
Cotto's off the hill, has been. John is the future. John is boxing, tall, rangy, good jab, good right hand, good hook. Come on, man.
Woo, I can see the shit storm coming now. All the fans. That guy's crazy.
Hey,
talking about John Wayne.
It is what it is. Hey.
Beat him up. It's not the same either.
His best days are behind him. They thought he was what?
At 140, he was
done after a Pacquiao, right?
That's true. Well, he lost to Pacquiao, he lost to Mayweather, he lost to. Austin
controversial. Mayweather was controversial. Man.
No.
That was controversial. Not. Many people thought he won.
It was a good fight. But Floyd beat him.
People always say that Floyd and Castillo, that's the one that people argue. And
the
maybe,
first one.
I thought Castillo beat him the first time.
And Floyd Maidana won. But
good fight. Yeah.
Right
now, you haven't seen the best of him. That was just a glimpse of him. When he fought Ruslan.
One camp.
Yeah. Six months?
5-6 months together. But, again, I can talk and tell you till I'm blue in the face. Proof is in the pudding. Let me show you every fight. Let me show everyone every fight. I don't want to hear all these assumptions or opinions. Every fight I fight, let me show you. From here on out, let me show you guys. Give me, you know, that's all I need. I don't need to talk about it. I can do it. Every fight. Put me in as the underdog again. Here we go. Let's go. I'm ready. Anybody. Let's do it.
Make some more money.